grocery day. I am literally at my favorite spot in the entire world. I'm at Trader Joe's. So I'm so excited to be here because it's pumpkin season. Call me basic, call me whatever, but I hear that Trader Joe's has some awesome fall items. Groceries, and I'm literally going to try some of the stuff right now because I already tracked it in my macros and I am starving. So the three things that I'm going to try are the ones that I am most excited for: the pumpkin spice cookies, pumpkin spice pretzel slims, and then the pumpkin Jojo's. It's a sad day though. They didn't have pumpkin butter. They didn't have my pumpkin cinnamon rolls. So we're just gonna have to come back, you know, we're just gonna have to come back. We're gonna try this in order of ones that I'm most excited for. First things first, we're gonna try the pumpkin spice cookies. Anybody else just sing when they're so excited to eat, or is it just me? Basic. Shortbread cookies with pumpkin spice and yogurt coating. Wow. Mm! 10 out of 10, people. Is it because I've been dieting for a while? Pumpkin pretzel slims. This smells like, why does it smell like Home Depot? What the heck? All right. Yeah, this smells like Home Depot. You know, like wood. It smells like wood. This is what it looks like. Pumpkin spice pretzel slims with crushed pumpkin spiced pumpkin seeds. Not impressed. All right, lastly, we're gonna go in with these pumpkin Jojo's. Whack. Not even worth eating the whole cookie. I am tracking half of that, and I'm having another one of these because these are so fire. Oh my God. All right, we tried all three. My favorite was obviously the pumpkin spice cookies. These are 10 out of 10, go get it.
The next day.
I was not feeling my workout this morning. I woke up and I was like, how the heck am I gonna do legs today? My whole body is sore. I'm still sore from Monday, and I was just full of excuses. So I pulled up to the gym and I was literally on my phone for like 20 minutes, just scrolling, procrastinating. And I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna go inside, take my pre-workout because that always makes me feel better, and then I'm gonna smash my leg workout. Rogue at the store, stroke on the smoke. They tell me to quit, don't listen to what I'm told. They help me forget that this world is so cold. I don't even know what I'm chasing no more. Tell me what I want, just keep searching on. It's never enough. Cup after cup, run after run. I wouldn't get one if I could find a fly. In the car, and I put it on my mama. And my bitch called, talking about some drama. I swear there ain't no time for women on the karma. They see the pussy or the karma. Man, I just wanna go flex. Bored on my teeth and on my neck. And I'm stone cold with the flex from the squad, and I'm smoking up a jack. It's time for Q&A. I asked you guys on Instagram to send me some questions regarding anything that you're struggling with fitness or nutrition. You guys sent me quite a few questions, so we're just gonna jump right on into it. Ice cream being your enemy, or sweets being your enemy in general. So oftentimes we feel like in order to see progress, we have to give up the foods that we love. You actually don't have to, sis. You can definitely have ice cream, you can definitely have sweets in your diet and still see progress. The way that you do this is by simply tracking it into your macros. I track my macros. I have all of my clients track their macros. And the reason why I do this is because it allows you to find this freedom within your food choices.
So if you're craving an ice cream a day, if you need an Oreo cookie a day for your sanity, you can definitely squeeze that in there. Just make sure that it fits within your macros. You have to eat protein or get a protein shake in immediately after your workout. So if you don't have the luxury of having a meal ready to go for you as soon as you finish your workout, then implementing something like a post-workout shake would be beneficial for you. You want to make sure that if you are implementing a protein shake post-workout, you have a high quality protein plus a quick digesting carb. These two are perfect together in order to make sure that as soon as you're done working out, you already start the building and repairing process and you are restoring the glycogen that you use during your training. I'm gonna go ahead and link the perfect post-workout snack in the description box below if this is something that you're looking for. I'm eating once or twice a day because of time and I'm used to it. Is this terrible? If you are only able to have two meals per day because that fits your lifestyle and your schedule, you just have to be mindful about making sure that you maximize those two meals. So you have to make sure that you are eating enough protein, you are eating enough carbs, and you are eating enough calories to help fuel you not only during your workouts but for your day-to-day life activities. Oftentimes, I would assume that you probably are not eating enough if you're just eating two meals a day. So more than likely, you're not consuming enough protein, you're not consuming enough carbs or fats to help fuel you during your workouts. If you feel low energy, if you feel like you're not making any progress with the gym, most likely it's because you are under eating. Next question says, how can I count my macros correctly? So I actually have a full guide on how to track your macros effectively on my website. Everything you need to know about tracking your macros, how much calories you should be consuming no matter what your goals are. I'm gonna go ahead and link that in the description box below for you so you can check it out. I'm eating healthy and giving into my cravings like you said, but I can't lose weight. If every single time you have a craving you give into that and you are not tracking your macros, you're not tracking your calories, and you're kind of just winging your nutrition, then odds are you're probably not in a calorie deficit, which is what you need to be in order to lose body fat. Soda makes you fat, so they say. Calorie deficit. I'm gonna say that time and time again. Sis, calorie deficit. If you are in a calorie deficit and you have a soda a day, you will still lose body fat. If you are in a calorie surplus and you have a soda a day, you will be gaining weight. Now, if we're talking about being healthy and losing weight in a healthy way and making sure that you're eating enough nutrient-dense meals, then probably soda is not going to be the best choice to make. But if all you're worried about is losing weight, then you can definitely still have soda and do so. Do waist trainers work? If so, which ones would you recommend? Zero. Waist trainers don't freaking work. If you want to be squeezing your organs and not be able to breathe right, then go ahead, wear a waist trainer. But waist trainers do nothing to cinch your waist. In order to get that snatched look, you have to lose overall body fat so that your waist gets slimmer. And in order to do that, you got to do what? Calorie deficit. If you don't sleep 8 hours in a day, you won't have muscle recovery. Yes, sleep does play a huge role in your body composition and in your progress. So if you have lack of sleep, that doesn't mean that you're not going to gain muscle, but if you have lack of sleep, you probably will be too tired to put too much energy into your actual weight training, which will then will hinder your hypertrophy goals. You know what I'm saying? Does the order of cardio really matter if you do cardio before or after you do weights? If your goal is primarily endurance, so you want to build up your endurance, then I would highly suggest you do your cardio before your weight training. But if your goal is physique driven, you want to build muscle and you want to look toned, then I would save your cardio for post-workout. You want to make sure that you're putting all of your energy towards your weight training. And then whatever you have left, you use for cardio. Is it bad to eat late at night because you will gain more weight this way? Absolutely. Absolutely not. It's all about calorie in versus calorie out. So you can literally have a bowl of oatmeal in bed right before going to sleep, and as long as you're in a calorie deficit, you will still lose weight. I'm interested in hearing your opinion about cellulite. Causes and fixes, is it hereditary? Cellulite is just body fat. In order to reduce the appearance of cellulite, you have to lose overall body fat. So that's gonna be it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. I hope that you're excited that I'm back on YouTube. I'm doing my best. I'm doing my best. Make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and do all the YouTube things, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.